BBC News. The United States says it will continue negotiating with Iran to revive the international nuclear deal following the election of the hardline cleric Ebrahim Raisi as the next Iranian president. The State Department said the US regretted that Iranians were denied a free and fair electoral process. The number of people in Brazil who've died with coronavirus has now passed 500,000 as it struggles to cope with a third wave of the pandemic. 2,300 people have died of COVID in the past day. Intensive care units are close to capacity in most Brazilian states. Armenians are voting today in a snap parliamentary election that will set the course for their country after its recent war. It's being held in an attempt to resolve the political crisis in Armenia caused by its disastrous war with Azerbaijan last year over the region of Nagorno-Karabakh. Reports from southern Poland say about 20 families have been made homeless by a fire that swept through part of the village of Nowa Biała. Local media say several hundred firefighters battled to bring the fire under control. Police in the US state of Arizona say they've shot and wounded a man who drove a pickup truck into cyclists taking part in a charity race. Six people were taken to hospital, four of them are critically injured. The suspect was shot when he resisted arrest. Six women have been detained in Istanbul after a protest against Turkey's withdrawal from a UN convention designed to protect women. It commits governments to pass laws against domestic violence, marital rape, and female genital mutilation. Britain's former parliamentary speaker, John Bercow, has switched allegiance from the governing Conservatives to the Labour Party. Mr. Bercow said he regarded the current Conservative Party as reactionary, populist, nationalistic, and sometimes even xenophobic. As speaker, Mr. Bercow was accused by pro-Brexit MPs of anti-Brexit bias. BBC News.